Hi everyone, welcome to Sunday service. Before we get started, let's pray. So here we go. Jesus, I invite you into this time where we learn about you, Lord, and where we learn about ourselves and who we are in you. And Lord, today I ask that your Holy Spirit would give us strength, Lord God, that we would just be dependent on your strength and your power flowing through us, Lord, in Jesus' name. And everybody says, amen. So on Sundays, we're talking about Jesus, our healer. And today we're going to talk about doing everything and anything in the strength of Jesus through the power of the Holy Spirit. We are to be dependent. That means trust in His strength, not our own strength. But before we get into today's lesson, let's get our hearts and our minds ready to worship and praise and love on the Lord. So here we go.
Yeah.
When I say mighty, you say Jesus. Ready? Mighty. Mighty. Yeah, I don't know if that was loud enough. Let's try it one more time. Mighty. Mighty. Awesome. Mighty Jesus. This is the God that we serve. So today our Bible story is found in John chapter 5. And as usual, you're going to need some colors and a piece of paper. Just one sheet of paper this time. And I'll post the colors on the screen as soon as you hit pause. And you can draw with me and help me tell our Bible story today. Okay, so make sure your paper is the long way. And if you're using markers, make sure the caps are removed. So we're going to start in this corner right over here. So take your blue color and draw a circle just like this. It's going to be our pool. Now grab your black marker and let's draw some people around the pool. So there is this pool called Bethsaida, and people would sit around this pool waiting for the water to bubble so they could jump in and be healed. While there's this one person that had been there sick for 38 years. So let's draw him right here. So let's draw a head and we'll draw him laying down. Just like that. Now grab your brown color and let's give him a brown mat that he lays on. Just like that. So Jesus saw this man. So let's draw Jesus right here. And he knew he had been sick for a long time. Now grab your red color and let's give Jesus his red sash. Just like this. Now grab your black color. So Jesus saw this man that had been sick for 38 years. And he said to the man, so let's draw some lines showing Jesus saying something to the man. He said, "Would you like to get well?" And do you know what the man said? He said, "I can't, sir, for I have no one to put me into the pool when the water bubbles up. Someone else always gets there ahead of me." So he basically said, I can't get into the pool, so what am I supposed to do? Jesus told him to stand up, pick up your mat, and walk. So let's grab your black color and draw an arrow right over here, just like this. And now we're going to draw our man standing up, just like this. And let's do some leg motions to show that he's walking. And let's give him a hand. And now grab your brown color and let's show him picking up his mat all rolled up, just like Jesus said. And just like that, the man was healed. Well, Jesus did this on a Sabbath day, which is a day of rest. And so when the religious leaders saw this man, so grab your black color, and let's draw some religious leaders right over here. And let's give them some hats because they wore hats and stuff like that. Just like this. Yeah. And let's give him like a long drapey thing. Yep. Yeah, good job. So the religious leaders asked him, told him, "You can't work on the Sabbath. Like, why are you carrying your mat?" And the man said, "Well, the man who healed me told me to stand up and pick up my mat." The man didn't know it was Jesus who told him to do that, or that it was Jesus who healed them. well, grab your yellow color. Later on, let's draw the temple just like this. And we'll draw an arch like that, just to symbolize the temple. Now grab your black color. So later on, the man who Jesus healed was at the temple. And Jesus was there again. He had slipped away into the crowd before, so the man didn't know where he had gone. Grab your red color and give him his sash. And then grab your black color again. So Jesus saw the man that he healed at the temple, and he said, "Now you are well. So stop sinning, or something even worse may happen to you." So with your black color, write the word sin. S-I-N, just like that. And grab your red color and cross it out, because Jesus said, "Stop sinning." Did you know that sometimes when we sin, it actually makes us sick, physically, spiritually, or even mentally? Well, Jesus told this man to stop sinning. Well, now the man knew, oh my goodness, it was Jesus who healed me. So he went and told the religious leaders who the man was that healed him. You see, we can become like the man who was sick for 38 years and be like, oh, this math test is too hard. Oh, this reading is too hard. I can't do it. No matter what I do, I can't remember my Bible verse. We can try and try and try to do something in our own strength and never have victory. Or maybe we do and are able to do it in our own strength, but it took a lot longer than it should have, or we didn't have the best attitude when we were actually doing the thing that was hard or challenging, or even worse, because we did everything in our own strength, we're now tired and can't do anything else. But you see, we're supposed to take our weaknesses to Jesus and lay him down and pick up his strength. You see, Jesus sees our weaknesses. He knows all of our weaknesses even better than we do. And he doesn't make fun of us for it, and he doesn't point them out. In fact, he invites us and encourages us to come to him. And he says, "Will you let me help you?" Just like he asked the man at the pool, "Do you want to get well?" Jesus is asking you, "Do you trust me? Do you have faith in me? Do you believe that you can do anything through me because I give you strength?" Jesus, your healer, wants to be your strength. Will you let him? Will you let Jesus be your strength today? Philippians 4:13 says, "I can do everything through Christ who gives me strength." Does it say I can do some things through Christ? No, it doesn't, right? It says I can do everything through Christ. So because of Jesus living in me, living in you, we can do everything. But we gotta let Jesus help us. And we gotta also admit when we need help, like, "Jesus, I can't do this, but I know that you can. You can show me how, and you can give me the strength, because that's what your word says." And Jesus's word is true, and it's powerful. So I wanna pray over you today and just bless you and just help you receive the word today, that the teaching that the Lord had for you today. So let's put our hands out, because the Lord wants to give you his strength. Lord Jesus, I just pray for the children watching, Lord, and for every single person watching, my God. that they would be reminded that you live in them and that you are almighty, all-powerful, and in their weaknesses, in our weaknesses, you are made strong. Your strength is perfected in us when we are weak. Lord, I pray that your strength would be upon the children, that when they're struggling either in school or at home or whatever it may be, whatever is challenging them, my Lord, may they remember to ask you for help. May they invite the Holy Spirit in to empower them, to give them strength, to give them exactly what they need at the moment they need it. My Lord, everything is possible with you. And I just speak this over the life of every single person watching right now, Lord, that they can do everything because you live in them. In Jesus' name. And everybody says, amen. So remember to tune in on Wednesday night at 7:30 for Kids Connect. And remember to like, share, and subscribe to this channel and these videos. And again, share the lesson with a friend. See if you can repeat the Bible story or share with them what Jesus spoke to you as you listened and as you drew our Bible story. Remember that we have Move Monday videos coming out on Facebook where we encourage you to worship and praise Jesus. And Miss Kristen has a video coming out tomorrow, so make sure you tune in for that because she's teaching us about the Ten Commandments. Remember that I love you, I believe in you, Jesus believes in you, and remember to put on His strength every single day. We'll see you soon. Bye.